who I believe to be the true birthers of choosing beggars. It's entitled Parents. Our first one is from Nathan5660, titled, Entitled Mother Tries to Buy My Lightsaber. So I just started my collection of NeoPixel lightsabers. These have lights in the actual blades, so they extend and retract like a real one would do. They can be quite expensive depending on which one you get. I took my new one outside last night after it got dark. I like to swing it around like a majorette in a parade. I'm not that good yet, but it sure is fun to do. My new one is black, so I like to leave it on the Kylo Ren setting cause it looks cool. I'm outside doing my best to spin it around and tried something new, spinning it while holding it at the end of the hilt near the pommel and speaker. A kid appears in the gateway of my front garden watching me. He must have been like 8 or something. He was in awe. His mom turned up too, and they watched me for about a minute or so before the kid tugged at his mom's arm and pointing at me. I knew what was about to go down, so I turned the saber off and went to head back inside.
That's very cool. Where did you get it?
Oh, I got it from an online store called Padawan Outpost. They got all kinds of different ones on there. Character sabers from the movies, made up ones like this, loads. For good prices, too.
My baby likes your one.
Yeah, they still have it in stock. It's about 130 pounds or something, though. Comes in different colors, too. Not just black for the hilt.
No, he likes your one. Give it to him.
Excuse me? No. Why would I give it to anyone? It's mine. I bought it with my own money. 130 pounds of my own money at that. You can't just have it.
Why are you so mean? He's only 8. Mom, I want one too. I know, sweetie. I'm trying. I'll buy it from you for 50 pounds.
Really? Yeah, sure. Let me go get the box. I walk inside, open my curtains, and turn the lightsaber on again. While looking at the kid and his mother, I take the box and beat the shit out of it with the saber. I then grab my phone and pretend to call the police. I didn't, I just stood there with the phone to my ear saying nonsense into it. They left rather quickly. I proceeded to just laugh out loud for 5 full minutes till my neighbor knocked asking if I was alright. She saw what had happened from her window upstairs, so I told her, and she about wet herself laughing. I'll never understand the parents like this that just assume because their kid wants something of someone else's that that person is obligated to give it up for free or even a reduced price. It's kids like this that grow up not knowing boundaries. This next one is by SnowStrawberries4044, titled Entitled Mom's Negligence Causes a Broken Leg, 2 Destroyed Bikes, and a Fractured Wrist. So a bit of background. I had recently purchased a new, pretty expensive mountain bike with my own money and was now taking it to a public park where nothing is off limits. Example, those signs saying no bikes, no skateboard, etc. And to describe this park, it's in an oval shape with an outer rim of tarmac, all flat, and a grassy middle bit. So that's the background. Here's the interesting bit. Me and my brother, who also loves mountain bikes, were at this park testing out my new bike. We were going pretty fast, but not so fast that we put anyone in danger, as long as they didn't leap out directly in front of us. As we were riding, we see a mother talking on her phone on a park bench. No biggie, people just want fresh air. Keep in mind, I am completely focused on my surroundings due to not wanting to accidentally hit something or someone. But as I ride, a kid falls out of the tree above me and I have to awkwardly hop over them, pulling up both wheels into the air. And as this happens, another cyclist runs into me due to me landing out of control and him not realizing. Total not his fault, he was just wrong place, wrong time, and I end up landing hard on my wrist. As I get up, I check the cyclist who was unharmed, but both our bikes were wrecked. So then I run back to the girl who had fallen, and she is crying, pointing at the lady on the phone, so I pick her up and take her over. This woman goes ballistic. She's screaming at me for hurting her baby, and I explain the situation, to no avail, and then she calls the police on me. And fast forward, the police arrive and hear her story of how I went out of my way to hit her kid with my bike. Then as me and my brother try to tell our side, the police don't really listen because we are minors. This godsend of a man points out the cameras, so the police say they'll look into it. Meanwhile, her child is still bawling, and I notice her leg is messed up, so an ambulance arrives to help. And to wrap it up, the kid's leg was broken, our bike's ruined, and I got a fractured wrist, and Entitled Mom had to pay for the damages, and I think lost custody due to her actions. And that's the end of the Karen that lost everything, her money and child. Edit, this was a while ago and just popped into my head and everything is all good now. An incident like this shouldn't be serious enough for someone to lose their kid, however, they should be taking parenting classes or just keeping a better eye on their kid in general, instead of when something like this happens, trying to blame everybody else instead of themselves. And our final one is from Thrown Into Deep Water, titled, That Time I Dropped Off My Nephew's Birthday Gift on My Brother's Patio. The entitled parent in this story is my brother, same one featured in my other story. At 15, I began an apprenticeship as a Blechner, metal worker specializing in thin sheet metal. Around the same time, my brother bought a house with a large garden. One day when I was visiting, my nephew, who had his 8th birthday coming up, talked about putting in a garden railway. Two of my classmates in trade school worked for the company that made those, so I asked them if they could help. As it happened, I paid about $100 worth in today's money, and they told me they'd see what they can do. A week or two later, they had fetched my nephew's birthday gift. A large cardboard box with 50 plus M worth of tracks, switches, and a couple station buildings and some rolling stock. In fact, the box was so big that it barely fit into the guy's, actually one of the older apprentices from the same company, hatchback car. My brother's house was only a few minutes away from the school, and he offered to take it there. Once we got there, nobody was home, so we climbed over the back fence and put the box on the garden swing, which had a canvas cover. That evening, my brother calls, and all he had to say was, "You should have called ahead." No thank you of any kind. When I visited a few days later, my nephew was ecstatic about his gift. He never thanked me either. I think my brother might have forbidden him from doing so. Instead, he showed his gratitude by being attentive, fetching me drinks and snacks from the kitchen, that kind of thing. My sister-in-law never said thank you as well, and probably for the same reason. But the garden was her domain as a stay-at-home mom. She really liked putting the garden railway in, arranged the flower beds so the trains can pass through them, and so on. And even months later, when one of his co-workers asked where he got all the railway stuff from, I put in how I got them. My brother again began harping that I should have called ahead and blah blah blah. Looking back, I think my brother was jealous because his little brother had given his son a gift that he appreciated more than any gift my brother given him. There may have been some jealousy involved, but the way I look at it is family's family and family will help out where family can help out. It's not a competition, it's just about making sure that the family is taken care of. Hopefully by now he's over it. I mean, you said the sister-in-law enjoyed putting the tracks in, so all in all, I'd say it was a good gift. Alright, that's enough entitlement for the day. Well, that wraps up this episode of Entitled Parents. If you liked the video, please drop a like, share my content on all of your social media, subscribe if you haven't already, and make sure to hit that bell so you're notified every time I upload, and drop a comment down below. Thanks for watching, thanks to my patrons, have a great day and stay safe out there.